الحمد لله الذي من على المسلمين بأحسن شريعة طريقة ومنهاجا، ورفع ذا أدب كريم درجات علا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، فقد فاز المتقون. Dear Blessed Friday Jama'ah, as mentioned in the khutbah last week, the message that was brought by Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam basically strengthens the messages which were revealed to the earlier communities through the hands of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is a message that is beneficial to all those who follow the teachings. A message that calls upon us to continue to maintain our taqwa to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obey His commands and avoid what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. My dear brothers, if we were to reflect deeply, if we were to think about it deeper, we will discover that the purpose of the sharia ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is actually a call upon unity and solidarity. The basis of the sharia must be understood and appreciated by all of us, brothers. The more we appreciate and practice Islam, the more actually it seeks to strengthen the unity amongst us. And the contrary is true. If we do not seek to understand Islam, or if we do not appreciate the beauty of Islam and understand it as much as we should, then the possibility of discord and animosity amongst us will increase. Hence today, brothers, I'd like to share with you three ways by which Islam seeks to strengthen the unity among Muslims and also all people. Firstly, it is through the call to believe in one God. Brothers, let me ask this question. What is the similarity between you and the brother who is sitting next to you? What is that similarity that you have amongst us today? Well, we know that for a fact there are several similarities. But I guess one of the most fundamental ones are that we all hold to the belief that there is only one God, and that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we believe in one Quran, that we pray facing one Qibla, and the fact that we are all followers of the same Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. This, brothers, this similarity in faith is one of the most fundamental similarities that we have amongst us. It is what which defines us as a Muslim and defines us as a human. Brothers, it is this fundamental belief also which makes us people and humans who realize their purpose on this earth. Why is that so? Because we would always have the need, we share the need to connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the nature is such that humans need to have a relationship with a higher power or divine being. Just look at how humankind, through the various ages and civilizations, try to establish that relationship, which then led to the birth of many forms of religion. In fact, it is innate in humankind to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to place our hopes on Him and in Him when a catastrophe or disaster occurs, or in situations where we find ourselves helpless and where no other humans may be able to save us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a beautiful analogy of such a situation in Surah Al-Ankabut, Verse 65. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فإذا ركبوا في الفلك دعوا الله مخلصين له الدين فلما نجاهم إلى البر إذا هم يشركون. Which means, and when they bought a ship and they are faced with danger at sea, they pray to Allah sincerely as they feel helpless. But when He delivers them to land, at once they associate others with Him. Therefore, brothers, when we face any challenges in interacting with our fellow brothers and sisters in Islam, when we find ourselves differing or disagreeing on many issues for that matter, then remind ourselves of this fundamental similarity of faith in the one true God. Before we even retaliate our brothers or sisters by insulting, denigrating them, or belittling them. Second, brothers, Islam also calls or seeks to strengthen the unity amongst us by calling to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the One and the Almighty. Just as how we share our faith in one God, so too do we share many things in common in our worship. Let us not forget that our worship is ultimately only for Allah, the One and Almighty. We pray, we fast, perform our Hajj, and carry out many other forms of ibadah. Why? Solely because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a very fundamental principle upon which we build our intentions and we build our deeds. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Surah Al-An'am, verse 162, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. Which means, say, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, indeed my prayer, my rites of sacrifice, my living and my dying are for Allah, Lord of the worlds. Let us remember, brothers, that whatever the differences are in our practices, for example, the differences in the way we perform our ibadah, whether or not we recite the qunut, or whether if we move our index finger during the tashahud or otherwise, whether we recite basmalah aloud or otherwise, let us not forget that the most important thing remains the same. And what is that one important thing? We perform our salah only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one God. The one God that I believe in. The one God that we all believe in. Brothers, do not let our differences in opinion in these matters cause us to lose sight of the common intention that we all here hold. And this common intention is none other than to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through our prayers. The third way by which Islam seeks to strengthen unity amongst Muslims and people of the world is that Islam also seek to bring unity through shared good character and noble values. Brothers, the basic ethical values of Islam which are brought by Islam, such as preserving lives, ending hostility, not to lie and not to be cruel to others, are universal values accepted by all humankind. And not just Muslims. And notwithstanding the differences in our, therefore notwithstanding the differences in our orientation, our school of thought or madhab and religion, and no matter how big the differences in opinion amongst us might seem, we must never forget that we are brothers fundamentally, first a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a human being who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's unique and special creation. It is nearly impossible, brothers, to homogenize the different ideas and thoughts among men. It is impossible to say that we all here should have one uniform thought and one uniform idea. But we can definitely unite our hearts and souls. Our hearts belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it can unite with Allah's will. This is as how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Anfal, verse 63, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ لَوْ أَنْفَقْتَ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ أَلَّفَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِنَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Which means, and Allah brought together their hearts. If you had spent all that is in the earth, you could not have brought together their hearts. But indeed, Allah brought them together. Indeed, He is exalted in might and wise. Thus, brothers, in our dealings with any other human, we should always hold on to this principle, and we should remember what Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us in how to interact with one another. In a hadith he mentioned, which means do not be envious of one another. Do not artificially inflate prices against one another. Do not hate one another. Do not shun one another. And do not undercut one another in business transactions. And be as fellow brothers and servants of Allah. Hadith narrated by Imam Muslim. Brothers, these universal values remind us that Islam desires for us to exist together, peacefully as one human community. These values remind us that it is important for Muslims to be the source of unity and harmony for all humankind and not otherwise. My dear brothers, this is the unity that exists in our Sharia. This is the understanding that we need to inculcate within each of ourselves. It is called or known as fiqh tawhidi or fiqh of unity, which has to be understood and appreciated by every Muslim and shared amongst Muslims. Now the next question will be, why is it important then for us to understand this concept of fiqh tawhidi? Brothers, this is to always remind us that the foundation of the teachings of Islam is unity and consensus. We start to build relationships on the basis of similarities and commonalities. We do not begin our relationship with others by looking for differences, khilaf, and conflicts. And even when differences in opinion arise, we still look upon our brothers and give our advice in a gentle, compassionate, and friendly manner. Brothers, let us not forget, and let us always remember and appreciate that differences in opinion should enrich our thoughts and our lives, and not to worsen it. Always remember the advice of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the event of Hujjatul Wada' or the parting Hajj, where he said, Ayyuhannas, O people, verily there is only one God, and all humankind are from Adam and Eve. An Arab has no superiority over a non-Arab, nor does a non-Arab have any superiority over an Arab. White has no superiority over black, nor does black have any superiority over white, except by way of piety or taqwa and good action. Narrated by Imam Bukhari. Hopefully, brothers, through our understanding of how Islam calls towards unity, every interaction and relationship that we develop will be based on understanding, compassion, and affection. May this realization of unity and commonality in our Sharia bring us closer to realizing the objectives that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set for us, and may we then gain peace and tranquility in this life and in the hereafter. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim. ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وتقبل مني ومنكم تلاوته إنه هو السميع العليم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين ويا نجاة التائبين.
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وأدم وأنعم وتفضل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك وأشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل الصحابة أجمعين.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا بربوبيته وإرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الخلائق والبشر. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه مصابيح الغرر. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله تعالى فيما أمر وانتهوا عما نهاكم عنه وزجر. My dear brothers, let us continue to maintain our taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember that life on this earth is a fleeting and temporary journey. And it is life in the hereafter that is perennial and everlasting. So let us all, brothers, strive diligently to prepare for the day of judgment before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us increase our good deeds by doing charitable acts and by serving our parents and our family members and friends in the hope that these acts would add to the accumulation of our good deeds in the hereafter. Dear brothers, recently we have heard the news of the epidemic that is currently starting or spreading in China, and it is known that it could possibly lead to death in worst case scenarios. What I am referring to is the H7N9 virus. Now this epidemic is of great concern as it is dangerous and one could be infected with it without even knowing or showing symptoms of the infection. Alhamdulillah, to this point we have had no cases of infection detected in Singapore. But nonetheless, brothers, I would like to urge myself and ourselves here, and for us to share this and remind our families to take precautionary measures. One important step is to be responsible members of the public. If we are down with any high fever, cough, flu, or what have you, then we should seek treatment and ensure that we have minimal direct interactions with other people, and to stay away from public areas that could potentially cause others to be infected or to even aggravate our own condition. This is one of those adab and sunnah which were taught by the companion Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Brothers, let us also at the same time observe good personal hygiene and ensure the cleanliness of our homes from any possible disease or virus. Let us all take care of our health and continue to lead a healthy lifestyle so that we can continue to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and our families with overall well-being, health and safety, and preserve our country from this epidemic and other deadly disease. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. ألا صلوا وسلموا على نبي المصطفى خير الأنام، فقد أمرنا الله بذلك حيث قال في كتابه العزيز: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ورضى اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي
رضي الله عنهم،
وعن بقية الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابع التابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم وفيهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات ويا قاضي الحاجات. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم ارفع عن أمة محمد القحط والبلاء والحرب والاعتداء. اللهم ولي أمورنا خيارنا ولا تولي أمورنا شرارنا، وارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا، وحول حالنا إلى أحسن الأحوال، وفرج ما نزل بنا من الأهوال برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم واسألوه من فضله يعطكم. ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.